draft is today, but talk about a PR blow. These NFL tapes have now been sort of exposed. Aaron Katursky's following this. Aaron, explain this story. What's going on here?
Well, so you remember we talked about it back in the fall. The players and the owners had this rather unusual meeting here in New York to talk about the anthem controversy. And we knew that the substance, they met, they talked, they issued a statement expressing unity, and that was sort of that. And now somebody surreptitiously recorded the meeting and slipped it to the New York Times. And I think we just get a fuller sense of the concern on the part of the owners about the president's wrath, and a concern on the part of the players that Colin Kaepernick was being blackballed, and their efforts to convince owners to stand with them.
What I've took most interesting, and maybe that's where I am or where we are in time, is like a Bob Kraft, owner of the New England Patriots, publicly praises Donald Trump or says he's his friend, but privately in this meeting has some pretty harsh words for the president.
Yeah, it says he was being unnecessarily divisive in his comments regarding the NFL and the anthem controversy. And you heard the owners respond with varying degrees of concern. Some said, eh, the worst is over. Some said, no, we need a public spokesman to get out in front of this. And they talked about how Charlton Heston was the face of the NRA for so long to great effect. And so they seem to have varying degrees of fear of drawing the president's ire any further and just wanted to tamp down. The way the Times put it, and I think it's probably, you know, right, and they've got the audio, so they would know that the players and the owners kind of talked past each other. The owners clearly concerned about the bottom line and declining ad revenue and television viewership, and the players wanting to be heard and the owner and wanting the owners to understand the depth of their concern about this.
What's amazing is that this meeting had somebody record it. That's extraordinary.
Oh, yeah, it is, because right at the outset you heard Roger Goodell say, let's keep this confidential, all right?
Right, yeah.
And you sort of knew that, you know, eventually. I mean, it's months later, so I think the efficacy is not quite as great, but it does come, as you say, when the NFL returns to the spotlight with the draft, while, you know, other sports have been grappling with their own issues of varying degrees, but this one I think still is pretty raw. And you know, it's the off season, so fine, let's see what happens when the season begins. But you have this group of owners that is not, you know, trying to understand maybe, but doesn't seem to believe that, you know, that this is a true concern, and,
yeah,
and really seeing it more as like a media problem or an image problem, as opposed to something that's deeply felt among the players.
Yeah, and the players were very very adamant in that they truly feel Colin Kaepernick is being blackballed.
Being blackballed. They said it outright, and we've heard it repeated that the players believe that he belongs on an NFL roster. They believe that he is not getting a chance for a reason. And be interesting to see if he, you know, lands somewhere. Yeah. But, you know, at this point, it's beyond Kaepernick. And we know that the protests have subsided. After that meeting, there were just a handful of players that kept up the anthem protest. And so the NFL kind of said, no, we're behind this. We're going to move on. They started, you know, they talked about public service announcements and other campaigns to get players involved in articulating some of their issues. And that may have helped. Whether the depth of the concern has been fully understood or realized, or whether the players are prepared to do anything more, I guess we'll have to wait for the opening kickoff.
Has the NFL said anything about this?
No. In fact, we reached out to the NFL to get a comment and didn't hear anything.
Yeah.
So, you know, assuming they don't want to make more of this than it is. And I do think, McGraw, that the substance of the meeting we broadly knew, but, you know, hearing Robert Kraft, I'm sure, criticize the president that he publicly praises was probably, you know, probably worth the audio.
Yeah, I hear you. Aaron, have a good day. Thanks for checking
in. You too,
pal. All right. ABC News.